Okay, so now the body has had plenty of time for the paint we put in to dry. So what we're going to do now is just apply the soap to the areas that we want to show through and not stick. I'm just using regular plain white Dove soap. Okay, we have some texture in here. We want some grain. Take our soap. Pull it over it. When we paint, our paint won't stick there. Right here, same thing. I got a little texture. Want it to show. Just put a little bit there. Here, this is the area that normally wears on a base naturally paint. Extra thick layer of soap, you can just spread it around a little bit, push it in. Smaller areas, same here. Smooth that around. Get a little up here. Right, and that's all we really want. Just to give it some areas that look like that paint has peeled off after time. Those areas will show through. Some buckle rash. And that's it. This one we're going a little bit light on the peeling. But you'll see after the paint, these areas will just clean right off. The paint won't stick there. After it's painted, the top coat paint, the top color coat clear, excuse me, cures. Put it in a tub, scrub that with a brush, it's gone. All right. See you then. Okay, it's been sprayed green now. This will cure for 24 hours. Then I'll go back. I've got a few spots that I do want to do a little touch up on, but those can be dried quick. I mean, I've got ways to quick dry it. But as you can see, the places where we soaked, The paint looks different even. It's because it's not sticking there. It's painted over the soap. And when the soap washes away, the wood will be left. Anyway, gonna let this cure. And then on to the next step. Okay, so our paint is cured. Now we're going to give this thing a scrub. Take off all the soaked areas. As you can see, the places where we put our soap starting to peel off. Just looking like the paint naturally peeled. And the areas without soap, of course, they stuck like they're supposed to, and they cured, so they stay. Now it's really important that you wash it very well in this stage, because you're exposing that soap that was underneath the paint, and you want to get all that soap off so that when you do your clear coat, it sticks everywhere. And once we finish this step of washing everything off, we'll hit it with some like 3000 grit sandpaper just to kind of smooth out any of these edges that are left. But as I've already said, we want this to be a little bit of a textured finish. Some of these areas that where we raise the grain You can still feel them through here, and that's what we want. Flip it over. Give the back a scrub. And that's that. Now we have our peeled paint effect. This will get cleared over. I'm actually going to let it dry for a little while. Then I'll come back and give it another scrub, because there's usually a few places that don't get it on the first pass when you go to clean it. But that's okay. Let it sit for a little while and dry, and we'll come back and give it another scrub. I see a couple of places like here. Peeling a little bit. But that's fine. It'll all come off. It'll get a couple of extra washings. So I'll be ready before we clear coat it. Once it's clear coated, I always use a polyurethane clear finish. Once this thing is clear coated and done, it'll be time for assembly. All right, thanks for watching. Hit like and subscribe, and let me know if you want to see more videos of the build process of the Panick Inc Custom Shop basses and guitars. Thanks again.